Good morning, 10.02 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on the East Coast in the United States of America. I'm T-Speaker 222 XRP, future millionaire with the side bet on XLM and future Digibyte OG. So first things first, I want to go over the technical analysis. We're going to go over the charts, but first I want to go over this with XRP. So we're going to go over the current technical analysis, trend, momentum, patterns, volume, support, and resistance. So Ripple XRP technical analysis, trade setup after a false break. And this is for everybody who is new to the channel. If you're looking to learn about XRP and you want to see what the current setup is, and also the current momentum and whether or not we broke out, we faked out, direction, reactions, and also support resistance, we'll go over. If you guys want to donate to the channel, it's been one donation in the last 13 days. There's links to my Cash App, PayPal, Venmo. Hell, there's even a way you can support the channel by donating XRP. I would encourage and appreciate you all to pay it forward. Do a lot of work, and it's nice to be appreciated. Also, if you want to join Tom's Army and get the exclusive content, and in month one get the emoji of me being abducted by aliens, I would more than appreciate it. We have 170 members. You get exclusive content that you can only get if you're part of Tom's Army. So consider those two things. So Ripple XRP technical analysis. Trade setup after a false breakout. Price appears back in the sideways channel $1 to $1.25. Pattern. Price is trading in a sideways channel, which is a neutral pattern, indication of market indecision. Trend traders usually wait for a breakout in either direction, although typically it breaks in the direction of the existing trend, in this case, uptrend. Uptrend across all time horizons, short, medium, and long term. But that, guys, you need to pay attention to with the MACD, and this is going to explain it right on the money. Momentum is bullish, but inflecting. MACD line is above MACD signal line, and RSI is above 55, but momentum may have peaked since MACD histogram bars are declining, which suggests that momentum is weakening, which means that we could be... That could be showing the reversal on the MACD. The MACD could have picked up that this is reversing back down. The OBV on balance volume is flat, indicating that volume on up days is equal to volume on down days. Hence, demand from buyers and supply from sellers are in equilibrium. Nearest support zone is $1.75. I'm targeting that 75-cent move if we break to the downside, because that is where the technical target is after the B extension, and we technically satisfied the B extension when we hit $1.34, $1.35 area. That's all I've been trying to tell everybody. The nearest resistance zone is $1.25, then $1.40 and $1.70. You can actually look at it a little bit different than that. It's skipping one. You can go $1.23, and then you can do the $1.30 or $1.35 before $1.40, which has been stopped at in both spots. So, and then if we want to do just a little bit of what XRP is. So, I wanted to do the supply curve details right now, so you guys can see exactly what's going on and why XRP is such a bitch to move. So, XRP outstanding supplied is designed to be deflationary. XRP is burned to pay fees for transaction via Ripple Net. Nevertheless, XRP liquid and circulating supply are massively inflationary. In December 2017, Ripple placed 55 billion XRP into escrow in order to alleviate concerns that a massive amount of XRP could hit the market all at once with substantial negative price impact. 1 billion is being released monthly to support Ripple's ongoing operation of RippleNet. Any unused funds are returned to escrow at the end of the month. On average, Ripple re-escrow 700 million and 300 million XRP become liquid each month. Ripple generated revenue from ongoing XRP sales, which account for well over 90% of the company's revenue. There are two types of XRP sales that the company discloses. Programmatic sales, these come from the company's XRP reserve and can be sold at a rate of no more than 0.25% of average daily volume. On defined exchanges, direct sales from XRP, these come from direct bespoke deals with institutional clients and include per Ripple's 2016-17 disclosures. Reselling restrictions to ensure its partners do not purchase XRP at a discount from the company and then immediately flood the market with sales. Ripple has sold over 1.2 billion USD worth of XRP through direct sales and programmatic. Programmatic sales are liquid supply curve takes into account the Ripple escrow mechanism as well as the founder's selling agreement to calculate liquid supply. As such, even though XRP's outstanding supply is a deflationary overtime through fee burning, circulating in liquid supply, are massively inflationary due to escrow release, founders distributions, and Ripple sales. At the current burn rate, it would take 20 years for the XRP ledger to burn what it distributed by Ripple and its founders every day. To date, Messeri released 2 in-depth research on Ripple supply management. XRP market cap may be 6.1 billion overstated circulating supply study for XRP. Very, very important stuff. I hope you guys appreciated what I just brought you before we actually look into the charts. But that is very, 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 very important stuff on XRP. And most people just look at the technical analysis. They don't look at the actual news and they don't look at the actual circulating supply and how much there actually is and how much there will be and how long it's going to take to burn it all. That's 20 years. So with XRP, very dangerous. You have that reversal candle in the daily, and we've had 1, 2, 3, 4 now. We're waiting for that shot down. So 118, this doesn't look good. We are, to me, we've reversed courses. It looks like we, like I said the other day, we snuck a head and shoulders in here. Left shoulder, head, right shoulder defining, and now we're going to come back down. That's what it looks like to me. Now it could pull up, but right now it is much too risky. And we're trading between the $1.18 support and $1.23 resistance. In the 45, though, we've come down through the 200-day and the 4-hour. We are being supported still by it, but I believe we're going to have a move down. I don't want to say it's 100%, but when you start looking at this chart, to me, I don't know about you guys, but I can see this, even with that little fake out, I can see that M clear as fucking day in there. That is a clear as day M on the 4-hour, and it can try to hide and fake out all it wants, but I see it in there in design. This looks like it wants to come down once it breaks this trend, and it's going to be a mess. There's not really very many scenarios where I see it going up right now with this kind of volume. It's just, I don't want to be bearish. I don't want to be that guy who's always the bearish dick, but right now, it is what it is, and we have to be very careful. Could we get a double top at $1.35? We were looking for that, but the longer this goes on and with the futures opening tonight, this could be ugly. Obviously, if you're in a position and you're an aggressive style trader, you can buy the 118 support. I would implore you to buy it more on the 113 because that's where the 200-day is coming through on the 4-hour and see if it holds up. But this is a very dangerous spot if you're trying to get your balls wet. It really is. Like, this is not the time to tickle yourself. This is the time to pay attention, let the chart play out, and see what's going to happen. Because the only other scenario here is you get wrecked. Bitcoin is on the ropes right now. And it's the same thing with XRP. You can see that M topping reversal that form. Now it's the sideways and the down is going to be brutal. If it breaks down to the 4-hour, we're coming down to 61,000. If it comes down to the daily, look out. That's all the way down at 48,000. And the way this set up now, this set up with a perfect topping reversal that snuck it in there in the 4-hour and this daily, this looks to be the reversal candle. It tried to break up, had a little fake out to 66. But if it doesn't break up out of this, it's going to pull down. The only other thing, if you're looking, is that maybe you could get a double top here and then it does it. But if that's what you're banking on, it could very well just be that's going to turn into an M. And it's already formed it. And when if this is an M topping reversal right here, this will come down some, maybe even all the way down to 53, 52,000 on this next drop after it breaks through the 60,000 barrier. So pay attention and be alert because this could be a very dangerous, very dangerous day. And or someone might get lucky if they're in and it decides to break up. But I would give it a 75% chance to break down, 25% chance to break up. Right now with XLM, we've got current resistance. Now let's go over the resistance support and then I'll let you guys go. So we're being resisted by 37.8 and we've got underneath support at 36.3. The next resistance above is 38.4 and the next support below is 35 cents. So immediate resistance 37.8 followed by 38.4 and 39.3. Really want to be over 39.3. Follow the immediate support is 36.3 followed by 35 cents and finally all the way down at 31 cents. DGB is starting to drop now. It's got that M built beautifully, in my opinion. So be very fucking careful. I mean, when you start looking at that, that's how I got that drawing yesterday. This looks like an M topping reversal. Right now, we've got immediate support at 5944, immediate resistance at 66, followed by 7, and then 7394. Immediate support 5944, followed by 5710 and 5518. 5518 breaks, we go right to 5093. If that breaks, we've got some problems. Hope this helps. Make sure to hit that like button. Donate to the channel if you want to pay it forward and show me some appreciation for all the time I put in, or simply join Tom's Army.